Hi, this lesson is on an algebraic concept called combining like terms. Our 7th graders are learning how to combine like terms with manipulatives called algebra tiles and an online application called Desmos. Before you continue to watch this video, you will need to know is how to zero out. If you do not know how to zero out, please watch the video called Adding and Subtracting Integers before you continue on. Okay, let me go ahead and show you how to combine like terms now.
We're going to use manipulatives called the algebra tiles to show you how we're going to combine like terms, okay? For example, I have is negative x squared plus 2x minus 4x plus 5 minus 7, okay? So the first one is going to be our negative x squared. That's going to be the red one, and it's also red because it's negative, okay? Notice that also that in front of x squared, there is no number, so it's automatically assumed a 1, and in this case, a negative 1. The next one we're going to have are the 2x's. So notice the box or the squares are a little bit different size from the red one because they're not of the same variable. Okay, so we're going to do it that way. And I have then is minus 4x. So notice the 4x and the 2x, the sizes are the same because both of them are x's, but the red one is represented because it's negative 4, so I have negative 4 of those, and where the blue one was positive 2, so I had positive 2 of those. So then we have is positive 5. So these are now smaller, and that's going to be our little units. So those are going to be positive 5, and then I have is minus 7, so that's going to represent the negative again part of it, okay? So that's the layout for this. Now, what we want to do is we're going to combine like terms, and I'm going to go ahead and put a line right there. Everything that comes on the other side of the line, the right-hand side of the line, we're going to use a method called zeroing out. And that's the method that we used when we did the adding and subtracting integers. So if you don't know how to do that method, go back and watch that video on how to add and subtract integers so it would make more sense. Okay? So we want a positive and we want a negative because a positive and negative will become a zero. So that's what we're going to do for each of these variables. So for example, I'm going to take this 2x minus 4x. So I'm going to take one of the x's that's positive, one of the negative, now that becomes a zero on that right hand side of the line. We're going to take another blue one, which is a positive, and we're going to take another red one, which is a negative, that becomes a zero. So I do not have any more blues, so I'm now done with the x's. Okay, so now let's take it to the next level, and we're going to take it to plus 5 minus 7. So plus 5 minus 7, we're going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to zero out. So I'm going to take one of the blues, match it with the red. That's going to be a zero right there. We're going to take another one set right there. That's another zero set. Here's another zero set. Here's the fourth zero set. And here's our fifth zero set. So you can see no more blues are on the left-hand side. It's basically all the red. So whatever's left over, that actually is the answer. So in our case, I have 1 negative x squared, I have 2 negative x, and I have a minus 2, so that becomes the final answer right there. Okay, does that make sense? All right, let's try another one so we can get the hang of this. So I have is positive x squared plus 3x minus 2x minus 3 plus 9. So let me go ahead and lay those out. So we have again 1 positive x squared, we have positive 3x, we have a negative 2x, a minus 3, and a plus 9 right there. Okay, so now let's go ahead and use that line. Anything that crosses over the line will now become the 0. So we're going to start pairing things up. So I'm going to go ahead and take the pairs for the 3x and minus 2x. So we're going to group those guys, the set right there, that's one 0 set. Here's another 0 set. So in this case, I do not have any more reds, so the blue that's left over for the x is going to be your final answer for that part. Okay, so now let's go ahead and do the next one, which is the minus 3 plus 9. So we're going to go ahead and take out sets of zeros for those. Okay, and that's about it. So there's no more red. So all my answer is left over in this box right here is then negative x squared. I have one of those plus x and a plus 6. Okay. All right, let's try another one. So I have is x squared plus 4x minus 5x minus 7 minus x squared plus 2. Wow, that just seems a long equation right there. Okay, so let's go ahead and lay them out. So I have is then 1x squared, right? I have is 4x's. Then I have 5 negative x. Then I have is minus 7, so the little units of 7. I have is a negative x squared, and I have a plus 2 right there. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and combine them. So let's combine the x's first. So we have is a positive 4x minus 5x. So let's go ahead and take sets of zeros. So that's one set. Here's another set. Here's the third set. And the fourth set right there. Okay? So now let's go ahead and do minus 7. But normally, if you notice, it was that plus 4x minus 5x, they were next to each other. But in this case, they're kind of mixed around. So you have to pay attention to this. I have is a minus 7 and a plus 2, right? Because it's the smaller unit ones, the small boxes or squares that we're trying to combine. I can't combine the x squared and also the 7 because they're not even of the same size. Does that make sense? So you have to make sure that the squares are of the same size. So when I do that, now I'm going to take one set right there of the 0. Here's a second set of 0. And that's it. So now I have no more blues for the little units of 1. So I'm done with that problem. So now we have one more thing to combine, and that is the x squared and minus x squared. So notice they're far apart. They're not next to each other. So you have to, when you do these combining like terms, look for the same, you know, variables, and you have to make sure then you're combining those guys right there only. You cannot combine an x squared and an x. As you can see visually, they are not of the same size. All right. So if I take the x squared and a negative x squared, there's zeros right there. So what's left is then negative x, because we have one of those, and we have minus 5 because we have 5 of those. Okay. All right. Let's try another one. I have is x squared plus 6x minus 2x plus 3 minus 4x plus 5. All right, so let's lay this out again. So I have 1x squared. I have 6x's. I have 2 negative x's. I have 3 of the unit 1's. Then I add 4 more. So that was a little bit, you know, mixed around because that normally the x's are next to each other, but we had more of this later on, and we have 5. Okay, so let me give you more time on this one to figure out how to do this. So go ahead and take the time to do this, and then let's come back and check your answers. All right, go ahead and try this out by yourself, please. Okay, so let's check your answers. So did all of your x's cancel each other out or zero out on that? Right? It should have all matched up. And so what's left is then our blue boxes for the x squared and the unit 1's. So then we should have is 1x squared and plus 8. Did you get that answer? Good. Okay, so that is combining like terms. So if you need to rewind this video to do some more practice, you can do that, or do some more practice online as well.